All right, everybody, welcome back to the 2013 Pokemon World Video Game Championships here in Vancouver, Canada. We've got an exceptional matchup for you. We've already seen two amazing finals, but now it's time for the Masters Division Finals. We will see who will be crowned the Masters World Champion. Will it be Arash Omadi from the nation of Italy, or will it be Ryosuke Kosuge from Japan? An amazing matchup. We saw a lot of Ryosuke yesterday, but this will be the first time we've taken a look at Arash during the tournament, so I'm expecting an amazing matchup here. Of course, both of these players will be fighting both for their country and for the title of world champion in the Masters division. Let's take a look at what last year's world champion and a couple of world championships before that, Ray Rizzo, has to say.
My name is Raymond Rizzo, and I'm from New Jersey, and I'm the three-time video game Pokemon World Champion. I'd have to say the community is probably my favorite part of the game. We're all really close with each other. I've made some really good friends playing the game. The game itself is a lot of fun, but the community is just, it's awesome. I have a lot of friends that I'll hang out with at these events, some from all over the world, where the only chance to see them is at the World Championship each year. And there are also some friends that, you know, live kind of close to me that we'll hang out with on a more regular basis. So the community in Pokemon is just really awesome that way. It is kind of different. At the events, a lot of people notice me, will ask for pictures, autographs, that kind of stuff. But, you know, if I'm just walking the streets back in New Jersey, nobody's going to recognize me, so it's totally different. It's pretty cool, though. My family's been really supportive of me the whole time. Back in 2010, my first year going to the World Championship, I was only 17, and they helped support me. They funded part of my trip, so thank you, Mom and Dad. My favorite Pokemon has to be Snorlax. I think he's real cute, and he's pretty powerful. I feel pretty good today. I'm feeling confident, but it's going to be a tough tournament, so we'll see how it goes.
Inspiring words from our retiring champion. Not on the stage this time, but he'll probably be back next year. Great to hear from Ray. Let's take a look at the present, though. Let's take a look at the brackets to see how Arash and Ryosuke got to this point. Of course, you can see Ryosuke, we saw yesterday, played both Seijin Park from Korea and Aaron Zhang of the United States in some amazing matches yesterday. Arash went up against Matthias of Germany and then Benjamin of Great Britain to make it to the finals. Truly international top eight here, and a really great set of matches from all of them, I'm sure. So, without further ado, let's go ahead and get this battle started. Let's go to Nick McCord down on the stage.
Thanks so much, guys. Great to see you again. Now, we have seen some fierce competition throughout this entire tournament, but we have two veritable titans of Pokemon sizing each other up right now who want that world championship more than anything. So, without further ado, our first competitor from Japan, Ryosuke Kosuge! And across that table, representing the nation of Italy, Arash Omadi! Who will be our world champion? Trainers, you may begin.
Man, there is nothing I like more than seeing both of these trainers decked out in their flags. It's one of the best things about the Pokemon World Championships here. As we can see on the screen, we are right underway with the battle. You can see Ryosuke's team on the top of the screen here. That's going to be Tyranitar, Heatran, Landorus Therian form, Cresselia and Thundurus incarnate form, and Conkeldurr. Arash is using Mamoswine, Conkeldurr, Heatran, Latios, Tornadus, and Amoongus. Really excited to see what both of these trainers have in store. We've already seen Ryosuke make some incredible comebacks after losing game one in both of his series, and I'm really hoping we get another game three here.
I am too. It's interesting to me to see that there's two Pokemon they have in common in Conkeldurr and Heatran. It seems like they've been really popular choices at Worlds this year, which is interesting. Heatran kind of stole the show last year on Wolf Glick's team, But Kinkeldurr may as well not have existed last year. It was so uncommon. The rule set's changed a little bit, and Kinkeldurr's been given a bit of a boost by getting the Iron Fist ability. But still, it's surprising to see a Pokemon go from basically non-existent to one of the most important Pokemon in the metagame. So Kinkeldurr are likely to have a decent series here just because both players have some Pokemon that are weak to it. Arash has some that are very strong against it as well, such as Amoongus. But I'd imagine Kinkeldurr will be big here. Another Pokemon I think will be interesting is Mamoswine, because it's really good against a few of Ryosuke's Pokemon and really bad against a few of them. So it'll be difficult to see if he can get his hits in if he chooses to bring Mamoswine, but if he does, it can do some real damage.
Yeah, definitely Mamoswine, one of those Pokemon that we see occasionally, especially back when the metagame was more oriented toward the genies and dragons. So it'll be interesting to see how that plays out now on the world stage. As we see at the bottom of your screen is Arash from Italy, using that Mamoswine and that Tornadus, both two Pokemon that we very rarely see, up against Ryosuke with the Kinkeldurr and the Thundurus. Both of these trainers competing on the world stage, on the finals, to take home the crown for their country. This will be the first time an Italian could win the world championships, so I'm excited to see how this plays out. How does it look from your sage?
Well, I think it's a really exciting first turn. You've got Thundurus against Tornadus, so that's Thundurus' advantage, but Tornadus has a Kinkeldurr there, so that's its advantage. You know, we've got Kinkeldurr, who likes to beat up on ice types like Mamoswine, but Mamoswine can, you know, target Thundurus, so a lot of things could happen here, but it should be fun.
And there is Thundurus going for the safer play, just going for the Thunder Wave onto Tornadus, getting that paralysis, which we've seen so much of this tournament, and especially yesterday from Ryosuke. The Mach Punch comes out from that Kinkeldurr, doesn't want to let Mamoswine get off too much damage without taking any in return, is going to deal, only a quarter left there, not a lot of hit points left for Mamoswine, but it is going to be able to get the Icicle Crash off onto that Thundurus Incarnate, is going to deal a lot of damage thanks to the ice typing there, and is going to get the one-hit KO. Arash comes to play, that is a mean Mamoswine, and it is ready to battle. Does get the one-hit KO onto Thundurus, and Tornadus gets the attack through the acrobatics with the Flying Gym onto Kinkeldurr. That fighting type is not going to want to take that, and Tornadus doesn't care about the paralysis. It's going to go ahead and get a one-hit KO of its own, and Arash takes an early 4-2 lead in the very first turn of this game.
Well, you couldn't ask for a better start if you're Arash. What an important turn. He knocks out two huge threats. We won't see Thundurus, you know, spreading that swagger this time. It's not over, though. It's worth noting, last year in the first game of the Masters World Finals, there was similarly a double knockout in the first turn, and the player who got that knockout, Wolf Glick, ended up losing the game. So he's got to stay focused here.
And out comes the Heatran and the Cresselia, two Pokemon that are more than capable of setting up for that. We'll be interested to see how the Heatran and the Mamoswine pair off against each other. Of course, Mamoswine fully capable of taking out that Heatran. But again, Heatran, the fire type, more than capable of taking out the ice type Mamoswine.
Yeah, Mamoswine's holding a Choice Scarf, so it's likely it's going to choose to come back and fight another day here. Icicle Crash, not likely to do a whole lot to Cresselia, and almost nothing to Heatran. So I assume it's going to try to come back later, try to get that Earthquake damage. So it'll be about what kind of switches Arash has here that he can use to avoid taking too much damage.
Yeah, and it's going to be interesting, again, to see if Ryosuke goes for that Trick Room that we've seen from him so much. Even though that Tornadus is paralyzed and will be able to, you know, under speed, getting the Heatran into a good position against that Choice Scarf from Mamoswine could be what he needs.
Yeah, I think at some point he's going to need to do it. He's just going to have to find the opportunity where it's safest to do so.
And it looks like the Heatran is going to go for the Protect, and the Mamoswine is not switching out, going to stay in to get that Icicle Crash off onto the Cresselia, dealing as much damage as possible to that Cresselia, possibly before it can get a Trick Room off. Only does about a third there. Tornadus U-turns out, is going to be super effective against that Cresselia and send Tornadus back to Arash's hand to send out a new Pokemon instead. Cresselia going to heal off a little bit of that damage, but still, you know, very bulky Pokemon. It's going to have a couple of turns left in it. Tornadus goes back to Arash, and we will see what Arash will bring out to counter this Heatran and Cresselia in the back. And of course, Cresselia still has yet to move. With that paralyzed Tornadus, that likely signals a Trick Room.
Likely, although Icicle Crash does have a chance to flinch, so Cresselia may not be able to get it off.
Yeah, it will be definitely interesting to see what Arash brings. Whatever, if he expects a Trick Room here, likely see a Conkeldurr if he brought it, or possibly even the Amoongus, just for the Spore threat, even though both the Cresselia and the Heatran are super effective against it. But it is going to be the Conkeldurr, is going to want to be keep the offensive threat up, not going to give anything away. And the Trick Room does go off from Ryosuke, and that's going to be trouble for Heatran now, just because Conkeldurr is out on the field.
That's a big part of why Conkeldurr's been so good at Worlds this year. With all these Heatrans, you know, Conkeldurr's here to beat it. A lot of the Heatrans have been slower variants that are meant to work in Trick Room, but even the slowest Heatran isn't nearly as slow as Conkeldurr is, so it's able to underspeed it and keep that threat in Trick Room. And Mamoswine, very fast, especially with the Choice Scarf, is able to create that threat outside of Trick Room.
And no Protects coming out because Protect was used last turn. The Drain Punch from Conkeldurr goes right on the offensive. Doesn't quite get the KO, but still deals a lot of damage. Make sure that the Heatran can't use its Eruption, its most powerful attack. Instead, has to use the Fire Gym boosted Heat Wave, which is going to get the easy KO onto Mamoswine and deal a little bit of damage to that Conkeldurr. A lot bit of damage, about half there, and give Cresselia a chance to deal some damage back also. Of course, since Conkeldurr went first, the Drain Punch not able to help heal there, but we'll have to see if the Psychic is going to be enough to get the KO on Conkeldurr, and it looks like, yes! It is going to be enough, and Cresselia does knock out Conkeldurr, and we're back to a 2-2.
Well, that's why you don't just count the game over once you start getting a couple knockouts. We're at a very close game here, and depending on what Arash brought, this game could still go either way.
Yeah, we do still have the Paralyzed Tornadus and the Amoongus coming out now. Amoongus we saw being huge in especially the 2011 metagame, but also making a resurgence in these later stages of 2013. And of course, that Paralyzed Tornadus is going to like that paralysis now because, he feels much safer.
Yeah, Amoongus is definitely the best Pokemon he could have had remaining. Tornadus' Paralysis could still make things interesting here because if it's fully paralyzed in a turn where Heatran gets to move, it could find itself losing its hit points in a hurry. But since it's slower now because of the Paralysis, it could use a move like Acrobatics or Superpower and greatly weaken or knock out either target here. And Amoongus will be the slowest Pokemon in Trick Room and able to use Spore.
Yeah, and Heatran doesn't want to risk giving the free KO, does protect. The Spore goes off onto the Cresselia, is going to put that Cresselia to sleep and make sure that there is at least one turn where Cresselia can't move. We talked about this in the pregame yesterday, but playing around sleep has been very important. And Tornado shows the superpower, making sure that Heatran knows that it is not safe at all. And of course, Cresselia taking a nice little nap. No bad dreams here.
A really perilous position for Ryosuke here. He's got to find a way to get Heatran an attack off against this Tornadus, probably two. But in the meantime, Amoongus is going to be threatening to sleep. It'll almost certainly fire a Spore in that slot, so he's probably going to have to keep protecting. But it doesn't help him make any progress, and Tornadus is going to be able to get some free damage here, and he's going to have to Cresselia gets a quick wake-up.
Yeah, as you see, Ryosuke has to go for that Protect. Does get the Protect off again. The Spore is going to be into the Protect, trying to buy time for that Cresselia. But Tornadus making a good adjustment there, going for the Acrobatics to deal as much damage to that sleeping Cresselia as possible. Stays asleep for at least one more turn, and it looks still like a good position for Arash.
Yeah, Arash is looking really good here. Unless he gets a fully paralyzed here, he'll be able to knock out Cresselia, and without another Protect on Heatran, Heatran will get put to sleep here. So there's two good things that could happen to him this turn unless he gets really unlucky.
Yeah, and we've actually seen this a couple of times now. Ryosuke has to worry about stalling out his own Trick Room.
Yeah, I mean, that's one of the dangers of using it when you're at this point in the tournament. You know, everyone is either using Trick Room themselves or they have a great solution to Trick Room, and in Arash's case, it's a great solution.
Yeah, and it looks like Heatran is not going to be able to get the Protect, does not try for it this time, does go to sleep, and Tornadus does get the Acrobatics off, and that is going to deal damage to that Cresselia, and it is going to be enough for the KO. Arash takes a 2-1 lead now. Just that Heatran on the side, that snoozing Heatran fast asleep for Ryosuke to take it back.
Another commanding lead for Arash here. Ryosuke does get the advantage of having stalled out the Trick Room now, so Heatran will be faster, but unless it wakes up, it's not going to matter.
Yeah, and a great move to not go for the triple Protect so that he can at least blow that first turn of guaranteed sleep there. If he had tried for the triple, he wouldn't have had this moment where the Heatran wakes up, gets the Heat Wave off, is going to damage both the Tornadus and the Amoongus, not likely to get the KO on both of them, but with that paralysis, it's much, much more precarious. And yes, the paralysis, Tornadus is fully paralyzed and won't be able to move this turn, but Amoongus does get the Spore off, and Heatran goes right back to sleep.
A brilliant play there by Arash. Now, if he'd done anything other than Spore there, he would have given Ryosuke a chance to win the game, but he's much less likely to win now. He'd need another one-turn wake-up and two fully, either one-turn wake-up and a fully paralyzed, or you know any combination of one more of each. So much more likely to come out on top now. Great move by him to get the Spore there, and he's almost clinched this game. He just needs Tornadus to get one more attack off.
Yeah, it's definitely going to come down to the wire. Heatran has that one turn of guaranteed sleep. Can only wake up on the next turn, possibly. But Tornadus gets the superpower off. That is going to be a KO on Heatran. And Arasho Mahdi from Italy takes the first game of this best of three set.
Yeah, huge, huge win for him there.
With the critical hit gravy on top.
It's going to let him know he means it, you know? That's a big win, though. Like we've mentioned before, it's really important to win that first game. It didn't look like it yesterday. With Ryosuke losing his first game in both of his best of threes and still coming out on top. However, both of our best of threes today have been two game sets, so it really is important to win that game. And Arash is in a great position now.
Yeah, it's definitely, as we've talked about over and over, the momentum is the most important part there. Arash has the momentum going into this game too, but you're right. Ryosuke has come back every time. He's gone down in game one against both Seijin Park and against Aaron Zhang, and he's managed to pull it out. I don't know how he does it, but he does. He managed to keep his cool and maintain his composure and pull out a win.
Yeah, one way he did go about making those comebacks was in both of those game twos. He led with Landorus and Thundurus. He's going to have a harder time pulling that off this time because Mamoswine isn't going to be having any of it. Mm-hmm. It's a really original Pokemon choice, I guess. It's not very popular in at least world's level play. But one of the things it does really well is beat the genies. And that's one thing that's been carrying Ryosuke so far. Those genies have been a huge part of all of his victories. So that could really help Arash try and seal this world championship and be the first champion from Italy and all of Europe.
Yeah, we have seen the Thundurus and the Landorus be sort of Ryosuke's comfort picks. He's gone to those leads every time he's been down. Or when he just thinks that, you know, he feels the most comfortable playing those. But we're going to go ahead and take a look back at these teams again. Ryosuke will be on the top of your team. The last hope for Japan to win this. He needs to win this game and the next game to take home the title for Japan. His team is Tyranitar, Heatran, Landorus, Cresselia, Thundurus, and Conkeldurr. And Arash will be on the bottom of your screen playing for the nation of Italy and the first Italian World Championships and the first in all of Europe. He's playing with a Mamoswine, Conkeldurr, Heatran, Latios, Tornadus, and the Amoongus. And both of these players know exactly what they want to do. We're going right into the game. Ryosuke Kosuge is on the top of your screen, playing for Japan. On the bottom of your screen is Arash Omati from Italy. Let's get into this battle. I am so excited to see this.
Hoping we see Mamoswine again. You know, I think that's Pokemon be a difference maker here, and I think it's a big deal to have that Pokemon that can really mess with your opponent's comfort zones. It's really tough to win if you just can't just fall back into what your team does best or what you're, you know, the most comfortable with. And I think that's a really important way to set someone off guard. One of the things that's helped Ryosuke in this tournament is that he's used his team much more than most of his opponents have used theirs. You know, he's really comfortable with certain things in his team, and he knows exactly how to play them. So forcing him out of that game is an important part of being able to beat him.
Yeah, and we see exactly that with the Tornadus and Mamoswine coming out. Bringing that Mamoswine, going to be able to force Ryosuke off his game. The Heatran and Cresselia, new leads that we've seen from him now.
Yeah, it's likely he's going to try to activate the Trick Room a little bit sooner this game, even though it didn't work out so well last time. So he's going to have to try to find a way to protect it a little better this time. Now make sure that by setting Trick Room, he's helping himself and not his opponent. But he can't.
Oh,
wow.
Heatran doesn't go for the Protect, and Mamoswine gets the Earthquake off immediately. Is going to hit that four times weak, double super effective attack on that Heatran. The Earthquake is going to hit. It's going to go all the way down, and that's going to be an easy one-hit KO for Arash. One of the highest offensive threats on Ryosuke's team goes down turn one. And Tornadus is going to get the U-turn off on Cresselia as well, giving Arash the chance to decide what he wants to do from here on out and maintain that all-important momentum.
Oh my god, it's an incredibly important knockout. Not only does he get the knockout, but he gets a free switch here too, so he can set himself up for basically any situation he thinks is likely to come at him. It's really daring of Ryosuke to have chosen to leave Heatran in there. It's not necessarily a bad play, even though it didn't work out this time. He's expecting that Arash would anticipate Heatran protecting and double target Cresselia instead, but that's not what he got. And that's what happens when you make daring plays like that one.
Yeah, and we also see the Trick Room as the Amoongus comes out. That mushroom has been the bane of many players' existence, and it looks like it will be Ryosuke's bane as well as it comes out on the field. We've talked a lot about being down. You usually have to play conservatively. Ryosuke decided not to go conservative, did the aggressive play, and Arash had an equally aggressive play right to counter that. Amazing set for Arash there, that first turn.
I mean, that's exactly why people normally play, you know, more conservatively when they're behind, because if you do take a risk like that and it doesn't work out, you know, it could be your tournament, and he's in a really tough spot now. This game is far from over, especially with, you know, Mammoth Swine locked into Earthquake. But, you know, he's getting Moogus out in Trick Room now to deal with. It's a really tough spot for Ryosuke.
Yeah, Ryosuke is going to have to really manage his sleep well here. That's probably the most frustrating thing going against the Moogus. You always get at least one guaranteed turn of no action, and possibly a couple extra ones. You see Mammoth Swine is going to switch back because it is locked into that Earthquake. Tornadus comes back out, not too worried about being under Trick Room, it seems. Is back out on the field, fresh from its debut in PokéStars Studios. We do get the Helping Hand coming out from Cresselia onto Conkeldurr, going to boost the power of Conkeldurr's attack, but will it be able to get an attack off? Amoongus goes for the Spore, and it hits the Conkeldurr! Conkeldurr not going to be able to use that boost and get an attack off this turn.
Now, Ryosuke is probably just hoping for a mistake there. That's the right play to use Spore on Conkeldurr there, but, you know, if he had chosen to Spore Cresselia instead, the boosted Ice Punch would have either knocked out Amoongus or been very close. So he's just hoping to, you know, get a chance to come back into the game here. But that's what happens when you fall behind. You know, you have to hope your opponent gives you some space. And Arash is smart. He's not giving him anything.
Yeah, definitely not. And now he has to hope for another quick one-turn wake-up here. Conkeldurr did use its first guaranteed sleep that turn. And now Cresselia getting spored, going fast asleep. Ryosuke's Pokemon both too tired from this long weekend of Pokemon battling. Conkeldurr takes another turn of sleep. Cresselia takes its turn of sleep. And now Tornadus gets to use its flying gym acrobatics. Going to be an easy one-shot onto that Conkeldurr. And things are going real south, real fast for Ryosuke.
Oh, he's in a really tough spot now. He's got a sleeping support Pokemon now. He's down 2-4. He's done, I think, literally zero damage. And Amoongus is still out in Trick Room. So whatever comes in is going to have to deal with Spore.
It's going to have to deal with both Spore and with Tornadus still being able to get free pot shots off on Cresselia or whatever comes in. And it looks like Ryosuke's last hope rests entirely on this Landorus Therian form. The Intimidate, though, going to lower the attack of the Amoongus. It's going to try to lower the attack of that Tornadus. But
not likely to have too much success with lowering that attack there. One of the reasons Tornadus is actually good now is Defiant.
Yeah, Tornadus Defiant giving it an attack boost, completely negating that Intimidate from Landorus and making it just even scarier.
Yeah, like Conkeldurr, Tornadus is another Pokemon that was basically irrelevant last year. But one thing that made him better is it has Defiant, which gives it two levels of attack every time its stats are dropped. So it counters Intimidate really well. And Intimidate's a big part of the metagame. A lot of the matches yesterday were coming down to keeping Landorus alive, and you know, Tornadus isn't really countered by that.
Yeah, Landorus going for the Protect, trying to make sure that it can survive the spores from Amoongus and hope that Cresselia can wake up and do some damage, but it's not going to happen. Cresselia still fast asleep. Tornadus goes for the U-turn with that extra boost onto the Cresselia, going to deal even more damage now. Look at how much damage that does with that Defiant boost. Over half to a Cresselia is not something you normally see. It will be able to recover some of that damage off with the Citrus, get it back up to above 50, but still very precarious. Cresselia should be waking up next turn, though.
Yeah, Cresselia has been out for a long time here, but I mean, that's the game you play with sleep. Sometimes you get short sleeps, like happened last game, and sometimes you get the long ones. He was able to get through the game when the sleep wasn't really working his way, and now he's got a big advantage because it is working his way in the second game, and it's making it even harder to come back from this deficit.
And now he gets a free switch. Arash gets a free switch to Mammoth Swine, which is going to just make that Landorus quake, shiver.
It kind of removes the option of stalling out that Trick Room, too. Like, normally, you've got Amoongus out there. Like, okay, I've got to stall a Trick Room, then I'll be okay. Mm-hmm. But now Mammoth Swine's the fastest Pokemon on the field, and it's threatening to knock out Landorus here. So suddenly, things aren't so safe anymore.
And the Spore is connecting with that Landorus. You can see it sleeping. Cresselia does manage to wake up, is going to be able to get the Psychic off onto that Amoongus, which is going to deal some damage, but he needed much more damage on that Amoongus to be more relevant. Almost half damage there, but still able to survive at least one more Psychic there. Landorus does go to sleep, but the Icicle Spear coming out from Mammoth Swine going to break that Focus Sash and be an easy one-hit KO on that Landorus.
Only Cresselia left. All four Pokemon alive on Arash's side.
Cresselia against the world. I have never seen a Cresselia come back from this big of a deficit, but it's always possible. See, the Twisted Dimensions return to normal, and we are just a few short turns away from having our first Italian and our first European world champion in Masters, unless Ryosuke can pull something miraculous off here.
Yeah, it looks like we're going to have a really momentous moment in VGC here.
Yeah, we can see the Icicle Spear is going to connect with that Cresselia. How many times will it connect? One, two, a couple more. Two times! Two times with the Icicle Spear, as the Psychic does come out on Amoongus again, which will probably just score it back to sleep. Make sure that Cresselia does not get a chance to deal any more damage. Does survive with 21 HP. The Spore comes out, Cresselia goes right back to sleep. And we've got just a couple more turns for Arash to whittle away that Cresselia and become the first European, the first Italian world champion.
He's playing the end of this game really well too. He's not taking any risks. You know, he got a big advantage at the very beginning of the game and just slowly making sure he keeps that advantage. He just hasn't let any Pokemon go down that didn't need to, and he's showing why he made it to this point and why he's about to become the world champion.
Yeah, we mentioned earlier that, you know, because Ryosuke was behind, he had to wait for his opponent to make a mistake. But Arash didn't make a single mistake this entire game. Gets the critical hit even. And with just a couple more Icicle Spears, is not quite going to be able to KO the Cresselia with the Icicle Spears. But Amoongus is just sitting in the wings, waiting to Giga Drain. That last little bit of damage is going to KO the Cresselia. And Arash Omati is our first Italian world champion here at the 2013 Pokemon World Video Game Championships. Congratulations, Amati.
What a flawlessly played series. Both games, every turn, he did exactly what he needed to do. He led the right Pokemon, he U-turned to the right Pokemon, he used the right attacks. I can't imagine a more impressive victory. I don't think I've ever seen at this level, you know, a match that was played where the winner looked that good. A really, really impressive series and a very deserving world champion.
Yeah, Arash looking great that game. Also looking great, Ryosuke, throughout the tournament. This is the end of his tournament, but he played phenomenally. Goes away with the second place prize. But Arash Omati, our first European world champion, our first Italian world champion. It's a really exciting moment for the game. I love seeing new countries come to these events and perform above expectations, perform well. And Arash has proven that with that finals, that he was the best trainer here.
He was, and I think the expectation should have been a little higher than maybe they were for both him, his countrymen, and the whole region of Europe. You know, sometimes all of them get looked down upon a little bit. I thought Italy had a squad of players. All of them could easily have top cut. Two of them did. You know, I thought Mean was getting overlooked. A great player. You know, he doesn't always get the attention that some of the other players do, like, you know, Matteo Gini gets a lot of attention because, you know, he made it to the World Finals. But there's a lot of great players in Italy, and they've been good every year they've been in this. You know, it's new in Generation 5. You know, Italy hadn't really been having the participation in Worlds, but since they've been here, they've been one of the best countries in the world every year, and finally they get that deserving world champion this year in Arash.
Yeah, congratulations to Ryosuke Kosuge as well for taking the second place, and Arash Omati, our 2013 Masters World Video Game Champion. We'll be right back with an interview with Arash right after this. All right, everybody, and welcome back to the 2013 Pokemon World Championships. I'm joined now by Arash Omati, our newly crowned 2013 Masters Video Game Champion from the great nation of Italy, our first Italian World Champion here with me. First of all, congratulations.
Thank you.
This is, again, the first Italian world champion. You're out there representing your nation. How does it feel to take home the crown for Italy?
Just great.
Just great, yeah. I mean, this is a country that's made it to finals before in 2011, but you're finally able to take home the crown. You know, when you're up there on the stage, knowing that you are three games away, potentially, from the championship, how does that feel? What's going through your head?
I don't know, I didn't thought that. I just played at best three games, and I see how it goes, how it went. Mm-hmm.
How has your world's experience been now that even before you were the world champion?
I was pretty unconfident. I thought that I was not good in best of three, and I was even unconfident about my team. In the end, it worked out well, so it's okay.
Yeah, I wanted to talk a little bit about your team. We haven't seen a Mama Swine that much. Occasionally we see it, but it performed really well for you this time around.
I started building around Mama Swine because it was simply great against which was used now, like Genies and Dragons, and did a great job in the tournament.
Yeah, it definitely performed really well for you in the finals, too. You know, you're going back home to Italy. You're taking home a win for Europe. I mean,
yeah.
It's I don't want to harp on it, but you're the first one. It's pretty great.
Yeah. I hope I'm in my country proud.
Great. The countries here, all of the communities are very tight-knit. Have all of your countrymen and everyone else been supporting you through this?
Senti, se sei stato supportato da anche gli altri paesi dell'Europa.
Yeah, sure.
Yeah.
A lot of people was cheering for me, and it was great. A lot of people was cheering for me, and that was great.
Yeah. What's it like being on the main stage, seeing all of your friends out there just cheering for you?
It's incredible. My win also belongs to them.
Great. And of course, with your victory here, you've secured an invitation to next year's World Championships. Are you looking forward to next year for 2014?
Yeah, obviously.
Yeah. Have you had a chance to look at any of the new Pokemon, how to think about sort of how the next generation might affect that?
No, I don't have idea. Let's see.
Well, we'll see when we get there. Of course, you've had a great season so far, and it all culminated today. Do you have anyone special that you'd like to shout out and thank for helping you get here?
Se vuoi dire qualcosa di particolare, se vuoi condividere un pensiero tuo particolare. Anche, sì.
No, nothing special. I didn't have a great season. I didn't want any the invite. I qualified through championship point. I did very better than what I expected. I was really the last person in there I thought could go to the finals and win.
Mm. Well, you definitely proved that you deserved to be in the finals. What was it like playing against Ryosuke, who we saw yesterday? It was a very strong trainer.
Che insomma durante le finali il tuo avversario comunque era un allenatore molto forte, quindi è chiaro che.
Yeah, I had a great matchup against his team, and also I did good moves, I think. I read them pretty well.
Yeah, I think that you played basically every turn pretty much the best move you could have made. What's the pressure like, because you know that each move could be the end of your season? What's the pressure like on each move to make the right one?
Well, I often went to for the safest move because it was not needed to make risky moves in these games.
Mm-hmm.
It didn't put me in the situation to do that.
Great. I mean, was there anything in particular that stuck out to you as sort of a defining moment in those games?
I think that in game one, when he protected each one while he double targeted his Cresselia, he pretty gave me the win at that moment.
Mm. Yeah, I think that was definitely one of the most important moves there. So, looking to the future, you're now sort of carrying Italy and Europe on your back. You will be the representative for next year. Are you excited?
Yeah, I hope I can do well even next year, also next year.
Great. Well, I'm looking forward to seeing you next year. How are you planning to celebrate now that you're world champion?
I don't know.
I'm sure all of your fans in the crowd will be able to help you figure that one out.
Ho detto che sicuramente i tuoi amici che ti hanno sostenuto si inventeranno qualche modo per festeggiare.
Oh, that's pretty true.
All right, well, thank you so much, Arash. It's been a pleasure watching you play, and congratulations again on becoming world champion. All right, everybody, we will be right back with TCG Junior Division Finals starting at, I believe, 12:30. So make sure you stay tuned to that.